First, I must find a power switch.
I have finally got Hogwarts to work. So...
You bring about your own destruction!
I'm just gonna do a quick Hogwarts playthrough.
Multiplier.
I have been challenged to pack a punch five weapons, five different weapons from the box. However, that is going to be highly challenging because the map, the doors on this map are highly expensive, so I don't know.
All your efforts lead to failure.
I'll be able to get enough points, survive that long, get enough points. Let's have a look. See, the first door costs 2,000 points.
I have drawn a line in the sand.
Let's get out of here. Oop, that's a crack. Hello, some zombies up. Why am I keep... Why am I doing that? Okay, I'm going to play... You stop that weapon just... I'm going for something else. Oh, I'm getting slightly confused.
My ammunition supply runs low!
Follows! It just seemed to be quite easy to get points on this map though, to be honest. So, even though it is a high price system, it does seem quite easy to get points. So... Next up, 3,000. So that was a funny thing. Rubber bang. To get all the points I need.
Sentry guard. Sentry guard.
Two sentry guards on the field. Two sentry guns on the field. Right, I'll save that. Double points for the next round.
The emptiness of my weapons displeases me.
Points multiplier.
I might as well just shoot myself in these rooms, I believe. Not that bad, actually. Let's put it this way, I don't think I'll be pack-a-punching in here. I do like that flip reload thing though. We have to flip it. I do like that actually. What have we got here? Ooh, the saw. I might keep this weapon. Right, I'm gonna go this way to start getting the power on. Power, I believe, should just be in this corner here. Like so.
Now you sleep for eternity!
Hogwarts as a map is probably one of our favourite custom maps, actually. It's quite a big map and fun to play. It would be better if there was like an Easter egg in it where you had to like do stuff in that. I don't know if any of the custom maps are all up to have Easter eggs. I do know on train there's like steps.
Sentry guard.
And cool stuff like that. So let's see what places we have a better one. AK-12, lovely. I'll be back. Sorry, that's a really loud impression of the
quick fire.
Sentry just blew up on me. See what we've got in here. They're milk question mark symbols. Open places. So this one opens this wall here, and as you can see, you just pay 2,000. It can be quite tricky to find the right spot. I did say to my friend that I will not use wall weapons, but I am just going to buy the M27
invulnerability
to get some points, and then I will swap my weapons around. So, Panda, I am not going to use wall weapons, but I'm just going to use this to get some points, and then I will transfer it out.
You should have slumbered in your grave!
The M27 is a really good, nice gun though. I do like it. It's due with more ammo, though. But it's in the assault rifle. It's probably one of my favourite assault rifles.
Face me at your peril!
Zombies. And I did use it a lot in Black Ops 2 campaign and multiplayer. And I'm going to try and open this area down here. See, like I say. It's so annoying to get the right spot. It's not like we're playing Halo 2000 and that's it. The spot unlocks. You just got to get it in the right area. And sometimes that just proves to be more hassle than it's worth. Right, I got that. Now if you come in here, pay another 2,000, it will unlock the stairs to Juggernaut. Juggernog, sorry. I always call it Juggernaut, because practically it turns into Juggernaut. So, at the end of this round, I will go and fix that.
But not body, Richtofen!
Just wanna hug. The other one is a hug. Right, so let's try and do it for this one. Like I say, I just have not got this figured out yet. For buying doors and that, this has to be one of the worst systems I've come across. Because just getting it to actually open. So tedious. Come on. Open, sesame. Go away a bit, and then I shall be back. Where are you? Come on, little fella. I just did it. I died on it and did it. That was just pure chance. I don't think you'll have to dive on all of them to unlock them. If it does, then it's a stupid opening door system. But if you come over here, now these stairs are open, which weren't open before, and you can come and get Juggernog. This door here leads into the main hall of Hogwarts, and it cost 10,000. So you know, to actually play this game, you need a lot of points. But you do seem to get a few points from the zombies and that, so. Again, this game does have a fireball ending. I think it is... I'm not sure if it's 75,000 or 85,000. But I do know it has a fireball ending, so...
Max ammo. It's multiplying.
Oh, the zombies destroyed my sentry gun. Oh no, it's still there. Oh, it's just farther in the distance, I couldn't see it properly. I'm getting blind in my old age. Oh, yes, the sentry gun does shoot you if you get it crossfire. It can shoot you and damage you, so be warned that you might take... It might down you if you're on low health and you get in its way.
Sentry gun.
Oh. up that, I can really do with that invulnerability.
Max ammo.
Spray and pray. Right, now I've got enough to open the main hall. And there's two ways to go. There's that way and that way. This way leads to speed caller. That way leads to double tap PhD and pack a punch, I believe. It's either the speed caller route or the double tap route, which has pack a punch. I mean, this area out here is a nice big area, so training zombies, if you're good at training zombies, it really shouldn't be a problem out here. But as I said in previous videos, I suck at training zombies. Oh! And I do believe my download's done, so I apologise for that. So, I apologise for that. I'm quite lucky I didn't go down, actually. Right, on the base of sheer fact... No, sheer luck. Sorry, I'm gonna go this way. I'd love to know what that's supposed to be. Now, there's two ways to go. That way, or this way. PhD is just in the corner there. And that does 4,500. So, double taps in that room, and I believe that is where Pack-a-Punch is. Really need to start getting better weapons. Hopefully next round I will be able to get to double tap, which is just too hard. Maybe sure that I look at 4,000. Help me out a bit. Whee!
Quick fight.
Kill the zombies, just kill the zombies. So here we are. Yep, Pack-a-Punch is there. And Double Points is here. And this is the viable ending, which, yes, costs 75,000. Do you believe these chests can be filled with souls? But I'm not 100% certain. So I shall wait for the zombie to catch up and we can see. Here he is. Come on, fella. Where's he going? Oh, I wanted to go and get double tap. Okay. Nope. Okay, then. That answers that question. So, you kill all these zombies. Should be able to pack a bunch up this round. I will pack punch the AK-12. Because it is only the gun. Off the wall. Sorry, not a gun off the wall. There's the P90 I bought off the wall. So I can't upgrade it, although I do miss the 290. So...
All your efforts lead to failure!
What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to go and try the box first and then I'll probably pack a punch next round. See what weapons are down here. G11 or G18, I'm not sure. Ooh, Desert Eagle. Ooh, kill shot.
Kill shot.
Kneel before me! Face me at your peril!
I don't think the bow knife is in this map.
Now you sleep for eternity!
Because I haven't seen it.
Die like the animal you are!
Leave some zombies and go and pack a bunch of the AK-12. You don't look so gay when you run with a Desert Eagle. I mean, I know that's how you're supposed to run with a gun, but yeah, it just looks so weird. I do like the Desert Eagle's look as a gun though. It does look like a sick gun. I'm curious, did I get his name of the gun right? Lock 18. That's kind of right with the G. I'm invulnerable. Look at this round, I'll be able to attack a flinch. It is a
Terminator.
You watch, but I want to do a quick video on end like surviving like round 30 or something. Which would take forever to upload. Well, not forever. Right, now that I've tried this out, I will swap it out if the box doesn't move. What have I got? I'm sorry, I'm not taking Dragon Oath. I just... no. Don't know why I did that, but to be fair, snipers can be quite funny in this map. In gun game, is one of the weapons you do get the intervention. Ooh, I have missed the intervention, but it is. Fun weapon to play with the intervention. I want to get the L19A, I think it is. Just so I can show you what happens when you pack a punch it. If it is the same as what it's like pack a punched on gun game, because it is a fun weapon when pack a punched on boom, boom, boom. You'll never take me alive. Kind of get the feeling that that's the whole zombie purpose. Just not to take me alive. So I really don't think that I'm not going to say that you'll never take me alive. So...
should have slumbered in your grave!
Oh, look at the little kingdoms all of them.
I have drawn a line in the sand.
Oh, look, we've got no hammer. This will at least allow me to buy speed collar. Deadshot's down there. And speed collar is in here. It's right down there. And this is a new perk. You can buy traps. Sweet, I didn't know that. Right, the light was... Oh, there it is. Thundergun. I'm not going to keep it though, because I won't get that many points from having... Desert Eagle no fun with him. Ballista! Let's go back to this again. No scope. No scope. Oh, I am on fire. Not literally. Oops. Payday. Is this it? Is this the end? Yeah. I just made a silly mistake there. I got one gun pack a bunch, so that's not too bad. So, yeah. Next time I do it, I might just have cheats on. And I'll explore the area a lot better than that. And then I will complete the challenge another time. So, from now, that is me going off. And adios.